satisfied. So I'll keep sitting here till the day that I die. This beast gets the best of me. I've got the curse of being too damn lazy. He's the worst kind of company. But if he can't hear me, someone help me. Blood red deprivations are the we'll be right back.
pop another.
I'm looking for Kid Kash. Okay, are you ready for Vic Mensa interview? You said yes? Alright, so you have the EP? Do you have the EP? No, the EP. There's a lot going on. Okay, and you know the single is New Bay? Okay, cool. I'll go get him. Yo, Kid Kash. I got Vic Mensa on the line with you.
Yo, what's up, fam? Ryan in Chicago. Cool. Beautiful right now. Very, very nice. Okay, sounds good. Early on, I was inspired by Common, Do or Die, Jimi Hendrix, Nirvana. Yeah. Yeah, I'm from Chicago, man. You know, I've always supported Chicago music scene and just love the music that comes out of the city.
Right. That's cool. Yeah, I'm a big Chicago fan myself. You know, being from the Midwest myself, so yeah, I'm a big Chicago fan, especially the artists. Yeah. So another question, like how did it feel when you graced the cover of the XXL for 2014 freshman class?
That was fresh, man.
Okay.
There was a lot of people from the city on the cover.
Right.
It was a dope opportunity. Good people at XXL.
Okay. Yeah, good. Shoot. Yeah, that was a dope cover that year. I think, Kevin Gates was on there, August Alsina. Who else was on that cover? It was a lot of artists on that cover, really, for that year. A lot of good artists as well.
That was one of the best ones.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Let's see. What else we got? So you started out with a group called Kids These Days back in 2009?
Yeah, I was in there for a little while.
Okay. Like, what happened with that? Like, because we noticed that the breakup right before the 2014 freshman class, like, is that something that you could talk about now, or?
Yeah. You know, it's just compromise, not a strong suit of mine.
Okay.
Nothing
I'm
really into.
Right. Okay.
But it was a cool learning experience, though.
Right.
Just learning about music and, you know, tapping in melodically and getting introduced to jazz.
Okay. That was dope. That's dope.
Hey, what's up, Vic? This is DJ Swamp, man. What's going on, brother?
What's up, fam?
Hey, nothing, man. Hey, first of all, man, appreciate you taking the time out, man, to talk with us, man. I know you're a busy dude, man, so we definitely appreciate your time. No doubt. Hey, I did definitely want to ask you, man. I mean, you're under the label of one of the, you know, probably going to be down as one of the greatest artists of all time in Kanye West, man. How does it feel to really be, between him and Jay-Z, you know, how does it feel to be under such experience and such, you know, great exposure that they can bring and the stuff that they've done already? You know, how does it feel to kind of, you know, I don't want to say follow them, but how does it feel to kind of be mentored by them, I guess is the good word?
Yeah, I definitely don't follow anybody, but it's really dope being with two of the artists that I grew up listening to, and you know, was most inspired by, you know, two of the best rappers of all time.
So,
I consider myself one of the best rappers of all time.
So,
it's
dope.
good company.
No doubt, I'm sure it is. How did New Bay come about? How was that, you know, experience, and how did that come forward?
I was just wilding out of Beverly Hills, Dark Mansion, Coos Coos version.
Okay. So was that a plan, or like you say, I was just kind of wilding out, and everything kind of came together on its own, and y'all was like, you know, that's a hit.
Yeah, recording every day, you know. And it was like my homie playing. Classic guitar, and then on the acoustic, chop it up.
Dope. And I know, man. Even with you, Mad. You know, back last year in April, man. You know, shout out to, you know, 30 plus. I'm sure it's a lot more than that. You know, singles sold. I mean, over 5.6 million Spotify streams. I mean, definitely congratulations, man, on your success just on that part alone.
Thank you, bro.
You know, I definitely want to get into, you know, with all this stuff going on with, you know, this upcoming, you know, election and everything like that. You know, I know you have, you know, a big thing out there, Respect My Vote. You know, can you elaborate about that and just how important it is, you know, not just this year, but to always, you know, make your voice heard?
Definitely. So with the EP, I created a campaign where download it for free.
Okay.
You can pledge your vote at respectmyvote.com/TOPGAGO for there's a lot going on in the EP. And I wanted to put the power into the listening hand. And right now, especially at the point we are in time, it's imperative that people use their constitutional right to be a part of the laws that govern them. We got to lead the letter off murder every day. And we're not electing officials that could hold them accountable. We're not showing up. So it's not enough to just say black lives matter on Twitter. If you really believe black lives matter, then you need to go out to the ballot box and vote.
Definitely, man. So, I mean, hey, a lot of times, you know, I think what happens is people, especially younger folks, you know, I think that there's still that scared mentality. They're scared. There's still that, you know, that snitch, you know, all that stuff, you know, where, you know, they don't really wanna let their voices heard, you know. And I think, you know, personally, you know, I definitely think
that, I don't think voting has anything to do with snitching.
Well, I mean, as far as Black Lives Matter, you mentioned Black Lives Matter, you mentioned, you know, the cop stuff, and that, you know, that's kind of what I'm talking about. You know, I think, you know, for those who have lost and finally coming out and speaking after damage is done, you know, I think beforehand, if people start to see things, you know, then maybe something can be avoided. With that leading up to, you know, having to go out and vote and being a cautious voter and letting people know, hey, I believe this person, you know, can lead the country in a correct way and maybe stop some of those things from happening. Now, obviously, everything's not gonna stop at the drop of a dime, but maybe someone who can check lead the change, I think, beneficial is just what I was saying to top your point.
100%.
No doubt. I think the man Kash over there, you ready to drop that single?
Yeah, I was going to ask him a couple more questions real quick, and then we're going to jump right into New Bay.
Okay.
So you got a tour starting up on the 21st. It starts off in ATL at the Loft. It's called Back With a Vengeance. What made you come up with the title for the tour called Back With a Vengeance?
Man, you know, just I've been through a lot in the last year, and I kind of lay it out in the EP and the music, and this is just kind of me coming back, you know, reemerging.
Oh, okay. That's dope. So, myself being a Detroit native, I see that you canceled a show in Detroit at Poppy Lux because of a Twitter post that was posted. That's what we said,
yeah,
for the 29th.
Yeah, the venue Poppy Lux, they tweeted something racist in the light of some of the police shootings. They retweeted some shit talking about fuck Black Lives Matter. And you know, I mean, when you say that, you're not just dissing a group of people called Black Lives Matter. You're just dissing anybody with dark skin, saying that their life doesn't matter. And being in a position where I can remove money, because this is about money, you know?
Right.
Money is a major factor in everything we have going on right now. And right. When I can not support and hurt the pockets of people that don't respect us, then they're going to think twice next time before they disrespect us, because right now they're shut down.
Right.
They close up for a little while, they can reevaluate, and I guarantee you when they come back, they're not going to talk about that crazy shit.
Right. Right. Now, would there be a future concert held in Detroit, probably at a different venue?
I definitely do some things in Detroit, and we're trying to figure it out. I don't know if we're going to be able to get it right now on this run, because it's just like I don't know, but no, right now. But I got all up with the Detroit, you know what I'm saying? Oh yeah, Detroit is really dope. A lot of my favorite artists come from Detroit, and I was having a good time in Detroit. This was just, you know, that venue. Right. Yeah, you got to make sure you get on the track with Big Sean and Dej Loaf. Oh yeah, for sure, they're both dope.
So check this out, WDG, we on the line with Vic Mensa, Def Jam, Rock Nation recording artist. And right now we're about to drop his new track called New Bay right here on WDG Underground Columbus.
Hang with us, Vic, real quick.
Hang on the line for us real quick, Vic.
Okay.
All right, cool.
I think I need a new babe. I let my down, I think.
That was Vic Mensa with New Bay right here WUDG Underground Columbus. Vic, you still with us? Hey, Vic, you still with us?
Is the number still going? Yeah. Hey, yo, Vic, you still there, brother? Big Vic, still with us?
Oh, man, sound like we lost Vic.
You got it off hold.
Yeah. Sound like we lost Vic Mensa, man, in the midst of listening to his new track, New Bay. That album, that track right there could be heard on his new album, There's a Lot Going On. So,
no doubt.
Hey, Vic, if you're watching us or listening, make sure you give us a call back, man. We'll be waiting for you.
Close this thing out right, man. Definitely appreciate it.
Oh yeah. Dope interview.
Mm-hmm.
Had a couple more questions for him, but you know, it is what it is.
Maybe business call, man.
We all know how that go with business call.
No doubt. Yeah. But definitely appreciate him for stopping by, man, and you know, blessing the phone lines, man, with his voice and with his wisdom as far as you know, what's going on in the world right now, and of course letting everybody know what kind of good music he's got coming up, man. We're looking forward to nothing but some hot stuff.
Oh yeah.
You know, so hey, It's Kid Kash and Swamp exclusive.
Oh yeah.
Tuesday edition. We got to do more of these, man.
Yeah, we do.
We like do, this. Bro. We need to do more of these.
Oh yeah.
Just for interviews.
Right.
You know. So that's cool. Man, we really did lose him, did we?
Yeah. He might be on the next line, you know, never know who he may be talking to, but it's all good though.
No, you're not on that at all. Okay, it's all that. Yeah.
But it's all good. So Vic, you know what it is. It's your boys, DJ Kid Kash, and our boy DJ Swamp Thing up here at WUDG Underground Columbus. You can call in anytime, brother. We'd be appreciating it.
No doubt.
Oh, yeah. So, about to jump back into some music with everybody right after these commercials right here on WUDG Underground Columbus.
When filmmakers view the world, their goal is to capture a moment or idea in time. Here at the Ohio Media School Columbus campus, the six-month film and video program helps young and aspiring filmmakers prepare for their journey in the cinema world. Learn scene shooting, set roles, advanced post-production, and fundamentals of motion pictures as part of the in-front of and behind-the-scenes training as an emphasis student at the Ohio Media School. Capture your imagination, finding the best ways to screenwrite and storyboard your films. Learn from media and cinema experience instructors who share their real-world experience as part of the 24-week program. Financial aid and job placement assistance is available for those who qualify, and enrollment qualifications based on completion, prior education, achievement, or professional experience. To find out more information, go to beonair.com or call 614-655-5250 and enroll today. The Ohio Media School, where broadcast media careers begin.
Digital and traditional media journeys are being created daily at the Columbus campus of the Ohio Media School to help you find your next career. With financial aid and job placement assistance available, the Columbus campus of the Ohio Media School provides instruction and industry experience programs like me, ready to share their knowledge of the media broadcasting.
Hello? Hello? Yeah, there's no one there. Oh, yeah, we did.
Have you ever wondered why so much pain, death, and suffering in the world, and just what the future holds for America? Believe it or not, there are grave national troubles and calamities that are about to come upon the United States, and you need to understand that this is going to impact our life. There is a book you should read. This hardy book lays bare the oncoming trouble that is shortly come upon the United States and Britain. Just go to AmericaandBritainYouWereWarned.com to order your copy. That is America and Britain.